we may find the words of today's gospel a little confusing, hard maybe to understand. Jesus said, ask and you will receive, seek and you will find. But I'm sure all of us have asked in prayer something of God that we did not receive. So how does that match what we're hearing today? Why is it we did not receive? Sometimes we think, well, maybe I didn't pray the right way, or I didn't pray enough. Or sometimes we think the point of the first story that Jesus tells is that we have to keep nagging God, and finally God will give in and give us what we want. That's not what Jesus is saying. Sometimes we think that God doesn't love us or care about us. So why should we even remain faithful and believe in him? I think these are good questions, and I think the gospel today does answer those questions. In the first part of the gospel with the story of those two men represent two types of disciples. Those who kind of live their faith as long as it, you know, they're comfortable with it, as long as it doesn't call them to stretch out, to move beyond their comfort zone. Just like the man who was sleeping with his children, although his neighbor had a need, but he said, look, you know, I'm already in bed. I'm not going to bother and get up and give you food. And sometimes that's how we approach our faith. We do those things within our comfort zone, as long as we're comfortable with them, as long as they don't impinge on our life or have caused us to make any changes, we're okay with it. But then when they're a little demanding, we said, well, no, that's, you know, I'm too comfortable the way I am. The other man is the one who really goes out of his way to help a neighbor, a friend who came to visit him in the middle of the night, and he wants to offer him some food. When Jesus says, you know, that the other friend will give him what he wants because of his persistence, he's telling us that we should persist in reaching out to others, in calling them to move beyond their comfort zones, to be more engaged and give of themselves to proclaim the kingdom of God. Not to give up on them because they say no once or twice, but continue to be that model that calls them to realize that God calls us to move out of our comfort zones, that our faith is not okay just when we are comfortable with it, when it's not a burden, when it's not a cross. Love is always a cross. Love always calls us to give more than we want to give. And it's a journey. We grow in it just like we grow in age and life. We grow in understanding, in learning, in wisdom, in many things. So does our journey as disciples. The second part about asking and receiving is remember how the gospel ends. Jesus says, how much more will the Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? Jesus is not talking about us asking God for a better job or better health or a better home. Jesus is asking us, do we ask the Father for the Holy Spirit? When was it the last time you prayed and asked the Father to fill you with the Holy Spirit? Now, what does the Holy Spirit represent? The Holy Spirit is part of the Trinity. The Holy Spirit is one with God the Father and God the Son. So when we ask for the Holy Spirit, we're asking that we do God's will, because the Holy Spirit have the same will as the Father. When we ask the Holy to receive the Holy Spirit, we're asking God for the gifts of the Spirit, for the fruits of the Spirit, for courage in times of distress, in times of hardship, for wisdom, for understanding. That's what the Holy Spirit is all about. The Holy Spirit is our unity with God the Father and God the Son. Just like we heard the gospel a couple of days ago or yesterday about how to pray, that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That's what asking for the Holy Spirit is all about. Yes, we receive the Holy Spirit at our baptism, but we have to activate the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives. We have to allow it to come out through our lives and the way we live and witness to our lives as disciples of Jesus Christ. That's why we give Mary such a great honor in our faith tradition, because she was filled with the Holy Spirit, and through that Holy Spirit, she said yes to God to become the mother of his son. Through the Holy Spirit, she remained faithful even at the foot of the cross. And when we pray the rosary, that's what we're trying to remember. It's not just saying the prayer, you know, without thinking about the words. But those prayers help us to remember how Mary lived as a disciple, as the perfect disciple for us to imitate. That's what the rosary calls us to. Not just to keep asking and praying, but to ask God to send us the Holy Spirit so we can become more and more like Mary.